Hey there guys, and welcome back to more Billy Hatcher and the Giant Egg. In the last episode, I didn't completely do all of my outro, and in this episode, we also rescued Chick. And in this episode, we're going to be heading back to Forest Village and doing Mission 7, Save the 8 Chickens. Yeah. So, we're actually going to be playing as Chick for the first time in this episode, and I actually really like Chick. I don't like his voice. As you can tell, it's a very annoying voice. Chick going one right there. And... no.
Chick, the crows have kidnapped 8 chickens. Your head is not even above the freaking text box. What is this? You've got to do something and save the chickens. We're counting on you.
Okay. I believe he's a little bit faster than the others. The guide suggests that, but I don't think it's actually true. They're just like, he may even be a little bit faster. But I don't know if he actually is. He just kind of seems faster. Especially when you don't have an egg, he just seems to move really quickly. Anyway, so obviously we've got to rescue 8 chickens in this mission, so let's head over here, knock this switch in, and that's going to rescue the first one. Now, you actually have to talk to them, or at least go up to them, otherwise it doesn't count as rescuing them, so remember to do that. Anyway, next up, we want to head this way. And this is going to lead us to a chick coin that took me a very long time to get in practice. So, who knows how long it's... Are you serious? That's what I hate about this. The ledges are all, like, way too high up. So you're pretty much always just going to fall off and your egg's going to stay up there. Also, there are no eggs around here. Cypher, help me! There we go. Let's try this again, shall we? I almost, like, started to do a triple jump then, but that would not have worked, self. Okay, come on. There you go, that's how it's done. Right, there's a one-up egg over there somewhere if you want it, but what you've got to do is head onto these blocks and go up here. Now, you can either ground pound the windmill, or you can get that chick coin. I'm going to go here and try and get the chick coin from here, because... Oh, I got it first try. All right. In my practice run, I just tried to get it by jumping out of the ring, and that took about 5 or 6 attempts to actually get it, so I'm glad I got that first try this time. Anyway, so let's just head over here, ground pound the windmill. It's going to start moving again. Excuse me, Mr. Big the Cat. And let's see. I want to head in the windmill, hit this switch, and there's the next chicken right here. So that is 2 out of 8 chickens freed. We're a quarter of the way there. Alright, next up, we need to head over this way, I believe, and get this new egg. This is going to house another... Well, I've been calling them, like, items or, like, item animals, you know, like the hawk, the gorilla, and things like that. They're actually just, I believe, called secondary egg animals, so this is going to house another secondary egg animal. Alright, so let's go ahead and hatch this. Also, I don't think I've mentioned, you can actually press the L button to center the camera behind you, and I don't use that very often, so... Yeah, just letting you know that that is a thing you can do. Alright, I need to want to hatch this as soon as I can, please. Really, that's not done it? Alright, well, let's go this way. Hit that switch on the wall. Okay, and we can head over this way. There's going to be a bunch of crows in here, so let's just take these guys out. I admit I could be doing this in a more stylish way, but that's not how we do things here. Anyway, I'm going to hatch this and get us the animal. Cook-a-dooby-doo. There we go, that's the fox, and in single player that just has random effects, whereas in multiplayer I believe that steals items off your opponents. I could be wrong, but I'm pretty confident that's what it is. Anyway, chick coin right there. Let's do that. It's going to open up the chest with chicken number 3 in it. Let's go and talk to this guy. Okay. This is a one-up egg. I definitely want to get it because I actually, in my practice run, I believe it's the next mission, got a game over. For the first time in practice, I got a game over. So... Yeah. Anyway, let's head down this way again because I want that ice comb. That slope up there, I don't think you go on that ever. I could be mistaken. Actually, now I think about it, I think you go on it a bit later, but I'm not entirely sure. I just don't remember going on it. I mean, you probably do. You most likely do. Also, I should have used that to hatch Richie, because we actually need him right here. Anyway, let's go ahead and get the ice comb, which we've seen before. Now, let's pick this up. And I really do need to hatch Richie right here, so... because we need to use him on the waterfall. Ha. Let's see. I need to go find some fruit. Obviously, because I need to hatch Richie. Actually, I believe this area has quite a lot of regenerating fruit, so... good thing. Also, I could have sworn I was going to lose the egg there. I thought it was going to crack. Run you over. Thank you. Actually, that's ready to hatch. Oh my god. Okay, so we need to head back the long way around. Hopefully the egg can get up there with me, because it tends to not do that. There we go. Okay. I probably should have cut this out, but, you know, whatever. It didn't take that long. So let's head back over here. I just kicked the mic stand. Sorry about that. Hatch Richie. Match our purple comb with our purple egg animal. Befriend him, and then let's do what we did before in behind the waterfall and fire him at the waterfall. That didn't work because he hit a piece of wood. Go on. There you go. Alright, now let's get an egg. So we can actually... well, actually, we don't need an egg to get over there. I just want one. Okay, I believe that there is a one-up egg. It could be a dud, and I could have just thrown off the one-up egg, but who knows. Anyway, head this way, and then there's a lot of enemies in here, and there's actually two new eggs that we want to get. There's this one right here, which I'm going to get first. This is going to be another item, and when I used the item in my practice file, it didn't actually do anything, so I don't know if it's actually supposed to do anything in single player. So I know in multiplayer it most definitely does. Sorry, Mr. Egg, that I need to collect next, but you were in the way. This is the stopwatch. I didn't get time to show off the fox, but whatever. I believe it slows down time in multiplayer. I think that's what it's supposed to do, and I think it's supposed to do that in single player, but it just doesn't seem to do it. So... I mean, I'll try it in a bit, but, you know. Anyway, next chicken befriended. That is... 4? Yeah, that is 4. I can count. I can look at the numbers in the bottom of the screen and see that 8 has been turned into 4. I don't know. Anyway, this bit is really freaking nerve-wracking. I hate that bit. Anyway, you're going to want to take this egg out of here, because you most definitely do not want to hatch it when you're in there. Because this is going to be... this is going to hatch into something very, very useful. And it's going to give us access to basically an entirely new area. Well, not entirely new, because it's an area we've been to in a previous mission, but new for this mission. And it's an area you probably wouldn't think to go to. Anyway, I need some more fruit. There's some here. Hopefully this gets it up there. No? Nearly? Come on. I know that the fruit regenerates around here. At least it should do. Oh, actually, let's check up here. Anything? Nope. That really did not fill it up. Are you see? Okay, there, let's... this should do it. There we go. Let's hatch this and get out my favorite, so far, egg animal. Kaboot! An amphibious martial artist. This guy is amazing. He's rideable. Bye, Richie. If you were rideable, I'd ride you. Oh, that's weird. Okay, so he's actually a land shark, so you can go on the ground with him, but you can also take him in the water and go this way. Also, I said go. You're going to want to go upstream. Remember this place? We went here with... when we came down here when we had the circus hat that one time. And you can use, like, 3 dashes, and then he sort of stops dashing for a little bit, but then you can just continue to dash like that, so... I don't know why he does that, but, you know, whatever. Excuse me. Come on, go. Keep it going. Alright, and once you're upstream, you're gonna go this way, and... come on, jump out of the water. I'm just gonna leave him here for now. You press X to dismount. Because I don't want him to get hurt, because if he actually can get hurt, and if he gets hurt a lot, he will leave, I'm pretty sure, so we don't want that to happen. However, there is another Kaboot egg around here, so that's not too big of a problem. I'd just like him to not die. Also, when on earth did I get down to 1 HP? Could you respawn? Thank you. Good job I got that 1-up a little while ago. Not that a 1-up's gonna heal me or anything, but, you know, whatever. The principle of it. I got a 1-up, I feel better about myself. Anyway, I don't know if this is a 1-up egg. This is probably a dud now that I think about it. But you're gonna wanna head up this way. Up to the top of this tower like we did in whatever that one mission was. And... where is it? Chick coin right there. Is there not a chick around here? I could have sworn that there was. A chicken. I guess not. Alright, well... Actually, I want to see what was in that egg now that it's here and ready to hatch. It was a 1-up. Sweet. So let's head back down. That's not the direction. Okay. That was completely the wrong direction. Get rid of that. Let's get back on Kaboot and get out of here. So, that is a very hidden... A very well-hidden chick coin, at least in my opinion, because... In the guide, it actually says that it took them, like, a really long time to find this, because basically you wouldn't really think to go upstream. I don't know why you wouldn't think to, and also, once he stops dashing, he barely moves. Well, he's moving a bit more now, but, you know. This actually kind of reminds me of Pokemon Snap. Like, you're just on this stream. I don't know why. It just kind of does. Jump, Kaboot, there you go. But seriously, though, Kaboot is... He's cute! Look at him! Freaking look at him! Look at him! And actually, if he gets hit, he makes this adorable little squealing sound, which actually makes you feel really bad for finding it cute. I don't know, I'm evil, apparently. Anyway, let's try and hatch this a bit more, because... I believe this is a small butterfly, it might be a big butterfly, I don't actually know, but we've sadly got to leave Kaboot. Everyone say goodbye to Kaboot. Bye, Kaboot. Also, this might be a kind of long episode. I don't know, maybe. Anyway, we want to head back over this way. At least I think we do. And go that way. That's what I'm hoping. Because I don't remember doing this in practice, but I'm pretty confident it's where you have to go. Yep, it is, because there's some chickens over here. And also some crows. Also Big the cat. If Big was an egg animal, that'd be awesome. Sadly, he's not. But if Big was an egg animal, I would surely introduce him to his friend over there. Anyway, I just remembered where Chick Coin 5 is. It's there. We are in the middle of the sky. Oh, I collected it at least. And that also opens up Mr. Chicken number 5. It's a great camera angle. Let's just get out here. And I believe... Actually, yeah, I've just... I actually saw the items, like, fall off me then. That was really cool. I've never seen that happen before. I died when I had a butterfly egg. That's just the saddest of stories. Oh, so sad, Bad Dad. Did I really just say that? Whatever. We got another butterfly egg right here, so... It's not gonna make up for the fact that we died while we had one, but it was the... It was the freaking beans! I hate them! Let's just get out of here and free this guy. Boom. Oh, go away! Ow, my toe. I didn't realize that they could fly all the way up here. Just take Clippin' and get out of here. Actually, now that I think about it, you have to kill all the enemies to open that gate. God dang it! Take them out, then. Excuse me! I didn't mean to try and hatch it, then. I meant to try and freaking... roll with it and do a dash. Also, that did open it, so I guess you don't have to take out both the beans, which is a good thing. Anyway, the next chicken is up this way. Get in this egg ring, and turn the camera, and jump over this way, and he's right here, so the side of where that previous guy was. Let's just talk to you. Yes, you're welcome. And then go this way, we have to kill the Big the Cats, and I should probably clarify that they are not actually called Big the Cat. They are Big Doras, I believe. Anyway, let's just get Clippin' because... He's there. I kind of wanted to get a new egg. this one, because I believe this is another butterfly one. This is already a hatching level, okay. Not complaining there, it is a butterfly. I don't think that was the small butterfly, I could be mistaken. And then the last guy is right here. Switch right there in the box. It's gonna free that guy. Mr. Purple. Excuse me, Egg. Let's go talk to him. And with that, that's gonna make the Emblem of Courage spawn. Pretty awesome. That's gonna be all the way back by the windmill, so we can just go ahead and jump in these egg rings. It's gonna take us back to where the Richie egg was, and then just simply dash over here. Keep rolling. And dash jump. And it's right over here. There we go. Mission 7 in Forest Village is complete. There is, in fact, only one mission left in Forest Village. But we can't do it yet, because Billy has 3 friends total. Also, that took 13 minutes. And we got a D. 17 emblems. And I am actually going to put another mission in this episode. You know what? Because, I mean, I planned out four missions in advance before I did this couple of recording. This and the previous episode were recorded in the same time scale recording session, so we're going to do Mission 7 in Pirates Island. I also want to do this now just so that we can continue on with Dino Mountain in the next episode. Chick and the Game Salesman. Remember the traveling minigame salesman? Yeah. He's back. He's got another mission for us. What does it involve? Lots of blue and red coins? Most likely. Anyway, I believe we did this in the previous mission with him. Don't talk to him straight away. Just go through the level without him. Open everything up, clear out some stuff, collect all the chick coins. You don't need to talk to him yet. Just gonna open up the way for pretty much everything. There's a first chick coin there. I'm gonna collect everything first. Because it gets everything out of the way, gives us a free roam, I guess. I don't know what I'm trying to say, of a level. Let's go ahead and pick up this egg, and you can immediately hatch it from those 3 things there. This is going to give us the speed shoes. Now, remember I said I thought that Chick was fast before? Look at him now. He's pretty dang fast, wouldn't you say? Yeah, he is. So, yeah. Anyway, this is the one where I got a game over, actually. There's another chick coin there in those rocks. Also, if you egg dash up here, wrong angle, you can get the egg to, like, fly into the air. Let me try this again. There, it, like, flies into the air, but it still counts as being held by Chick, so I don't know why it does that, but whatever. Let's open this door up. Go ahead and head through here. As you can see, I'm opening up all the doors, and I'm going to kill off some crows before we actually do the traveling minigame salesman's minigame that he's selling. So, it's a good plan. Anyway, chick coin there. Plain and simple. Also, I freaking love the speed shoes. Just saying. Anyway, this way next. I think I can actually do this mission pretty quickly. That's what I'm aiming for. Okay. That's what I'm aiming for. And if you die, by the way, you get put right back by the minigame salesman, so it's kind of a pain if you do die. Especially just here, because there is a chick coin down there. I recommend you take this small egg. I don't want to collect fruit. Okay, you go down there and fall in a pit. There you go. Alright, you gotta jump, and then you gotta... Oh, I missed it! Crud biscuits. Okay, this is a bad idea, this is a bad idea. Oh my god. Okay, because I'm so fast, when I missed it on my practice run, actually, and if you dash up there with an egg, you're gonna just kind of fly off the sides, but I'm gonna try it. That's not what I meant to do at all, but I got the chick coin, so all's good. And as you can see, I'm back here. But now that I did die, there's a kind of cool shortcut I want to show off. That. I love that. I don't know if it's just me, but whenever Chick jumps, listen. I just think it sounds like he's saying U-Haul. I don't know. Do you guys think that? Listen to him. Yahaw! Anyway, another cannon fire above the flag thing. There we go. And I believe chick coin right there. There we go. That is every collectible in this mission. This went by quicker than I thought it was going to do, but now we actually have to do the mission itself. So, let's head this way. And if we head back over here, this is going to do something very kind of cool. Whee! I just think that looks awesome for some reason. It just sends you right back to the beginning of the mission. And now let's talk to the chicken guy.
Hey, you! Yeah, you! Got any tasty star bits? I'm known as the traveling minigame salesman. Why don't you play a game or two? You can win something really nice. A sucker born every minute. Since this may be your first time, I'll give you a simple explanation of the rules. When I give you the signal, you need to collect all of the chicken coins that appear. And that's it. Sounds easy, right? Of course, there's a little time limit of 20 minutes and all. But don't worry about that. All you need to do is continuously collect coins and you'll receive plenty of nice time bonuses. If you can break 40 coins, I'll give you something good.
This ought to be good.
Well then, are you ready? Ready? Go!
Okay, guy. You basically just have to break 40 points and you get the Emblem of Courage. I don't believe there's any other bonus. I mean, there's probably like a rank bonus or something if you collect every single chick coin. However, chicken coin or whatever. I do, however, believe it is completely impossible to collect them all in this mission because there are so many and you get like so little time. Also, I just realized that I don't have my speed shoes anymore because I died. I really should have picked those up again, but honestly, I think it's going to help me not to have them because I tend to get a little bit reckless with them, so yeah. However, they would obviously help for getting through this a little bit quicker, but I am not complaining because, well, I kind of am. I don't know. Anyway, we did a mission like this in Forest Village. Pretty much just the same. We can just leave the egg on this thing. Now that I've learned, you can actually just, you know, do that. After it hits it 10 times, it basically counts as 5, I believe. There's 5 chicken coins, so not bad. We only need 5 more to get this guy's record. However, we also need to get to the end of the level, so that could be a problem. Now that these chicken coins are here, it actually helps you get your jump a bit better there, I guess, and not fail to land it. Okay, keep doing this. Do. I probably don't even need to do that because there was plenty more coins down here. Do that and keep on going. We don't even need to collect those ones because we've got 46 now. We just need to get to the end of the level, so let's do that. I actually aimed a bit too high there. That could have been bad. And head down here. I can't see the gaps. Okay, camera, what are you doing? Avoid the ribbon right there. And then I believe just over here. Yep, and as you can see, I mean, without the speed shoes, I didn't, like, if I had the speed shoes, I would have done that a little bit quicker, but, I mean, you have to just wait for the timer to run out anyway. Anyway, but it's a difficult one, honestly. I was so scared I was going to die before it said time up. Wow, congratulations! This is one and only special grand prize emblem. There's only one in the world. You should be proud of yourself.
I was hoping to win it myself.
He was hoping to win it himself, yet he was the one holding on to it. Okay, guy. Just get the emblem, be out of here, and that is unfortunately gonna do it for this episode. Good morning to you too, even though it's 9:55 at night. Thank you all for watching this episode of Billy Hatcher and the Giant Egg. Did I even say that in the opening? I don't remember saying the full name of the game, but whatever. In the next episode, I just did a little finger wag thing, I'm like pointing, I'm like, in the next episode, we are going to be going back to Dino Mountain, and we're going to do Mission 5, Mission 6, and maybe Mission 7. Maybe. It depends how quickly I get through them. But anyway, that's going to do it for this episode. If you haven't already, Make sure to hit the subscribe button, it really helps me out a ton, and you get to watch my content every day. That is the vlog outro, what am I doing? You get to watch my content when I release it. And leave a like and a comment if you enjoyed this episode or this series in general. Make sure to subscribe to the show so you get notified of every episode that comes out, because we all know how crappy YouTube subscription boxes are. And I will see you guys in the next episode.
Wow.
And also it's Sonic. So, Sonic. Sonic from Sonic DX. Don't know why it says Sonic three times there, whatever. It's my friend Sonic.
Oh, that's me then. I'm Blue Tanuki.
I'm Sean of Nintendo.
I'm Retro Broadcast.
Wait, actually, War comes before S.
Also, no.
I went by your name, Sid, sorry.
Does it matter?
Oh my god, just an onslaught of audio.